20 years ago, Michael Jackson had the whole world at his feet, watching his every move. He was the undisputed king of pop. He defined pop music for a decade. But what was so special about Michael Jackson?
Michael is so successful, and he's accomplished so much in his life, that I personally feel that it has led him down a very lonely road.
Michael was a singing, you know, dancing sensation. He took the music to a completely different level.
Very few individuals who have been allowed to have that kind of fame. You know, oh, what a cost, though. At what cost?
He's influenced styles, he's influenced singing, he's influenced dancing, he's influenced videos for sure. He is the ultimate artist.
But even by showbiz standards, Jackson began to be viewed as increasingly strange. When Michael Jackson was arrested in 2003, it looked like the end of the road for the King of Pop. He stood accused of vile crimes in court, his carefully crafted image seemingly tarnished forever. But 2 years later, Jackson was exonerated. With the trial behind him, he disappeared from view, his career surely over. With all we think we know about Michael Jackson, it's easy to forget what the fuss was about in the first place. It was, of course, his music. The sheer scale of his success has never been equaled. He's had the biggest selling album of all time, the largest audience ever, the biggest selling video, and won more awards than any other artist, including 8 Grammys in one night. The 1980s and 90s were the reign of the King of Pop. But during much of the 1970s, the charts were ruled by the Jacksons.
I'm going to give you the old songs, the old-fashioned way.
Michael Jackson's life as a performer began at an early age, when he and his brothers Jackie, Tito, Jermaine and Marlon found they shared a talent for making music.
The next thing we're gonna do was one of the songs, one of our family things, so I hope you enjoy it.
We thank you.
My sister and I, we loved to sing together. And after we got married and when we were recording, Joe and I used to sing a lot. So when the kids came along and we sang together, they were just little kids. When the television would break down and it's snowing outside, we'd just sit in the house and sing all day on Saturday and Sunday or something like that until we got the TV back. We sang country western songs, we'd sing folk songs. And I discovered then they had perfect harmony. And so that's what happened.
Michael Jackson was born in 1958 in Gary, Indiana. His father, Joe, worked in the local steelworks. Joe's own dreams of a music career at first prevented him from seeing his children's talent.
I said, why don't you listen to them? I think they sound pretty good. And so he finally, after persuading him, he finally listened.
Tito was playing a Motown song, and we started making harmony, and he said, wow. So he started investing time and money into getting instruments and us getting together and start singing more Motown music. We would move the table because it was a small house the size of a two-car garage. And we would pull all our stuff out and we'd be rehearsing and the doorbell would ring and there'd be a neighbor across the street. But can they come out to play? And I said, no, not today. We have a show that we're practicing.
He started working with them every single day, every day. And he never let go, he never stopped. And he kept pushing them to improve and to get better and to get better. And yes, they did.
By 1965, the Jackson Boys had begun to make a name for themselves in Chicago talent shows and were finally given an audition by the Motown record label founded by Berry Gordy.
We'd like you to meet the man that was responsible for getting the whole Motown story started, president of the Motown Record Corporation, Mr. Berry Gordy. Hi, old buddy.
I realized that Michael had something very, very special. When we auditioned them, it was like, whoa. I mean, they were all great, but he was very, very much the centerpiece.
He sang a couple of James Brown songs, and he was doing some James Brown moves. We just took what James had to offer and added some Michael to it. Berry Gordy absolutely was blown away by the Jackson 5, like we all were. The focal point of them was Michael, because he was so young and so tiny and so talented. It was like looking at a little old man performing.
Berry Gordy came up with the idea of announcing that Diana Ross, one of Motown's leading artists, had discovered his new protégés.
Martin, our audience tonight is Diana Ross of the Supremes, who discovered the Jackson 5 in Gary, Indiana. Wasn't it Gary, Indiana?
Indiana.
Stand up and take a bow there. Diana Ross.
Michael and I would share the lead part. He would sing a part, then I would sing a part, which is sort of representative of what we did with I Want You Back in ABC.
They alternated, Jermaine and Michael, as lead singers. Berry Gordy had this idea of put the little one up front. And Michael, of course, took the floor at that point and said, okay, I'm the leader. But he was a natural-born leader, though. As long as I can remember, he's always had a mind of his own.
By 1969, Berry Gordy had sent the Jackson 5 to Los Angeles, where they began to get noticed.
One day, we could go anywhere. We could go to a restaurant, we could go to stores to shop. And the next day, we couldn't go anywhere. I mean, it was really that fast. And I think that it took the greatest toll on Michael because he had the greatest responsibility and the greatest